Hi students, good evening everybody. Look at the problems of indefinite integration, method of substitution. Here, interesting problem. Integral e power x into 1 plus x upon cos square of x e power x dx. Now here particularly, cos square of x e power x we have. So, let me take x e power x equal to t. Did you understand? So, since we have internal function x e power x, let it be t. So, before writing the derivative, we have product rule. You remember the product rule? First function into derivative of second function plus second function into derivative of first function. This is the product rule we use in differentiation. Here, what is the first function? X. Derivative of e power x is e power x plus e power x. Derivative of x is 1. Okay, put bracket. X derivative dx equal to dt. Hope it is clear. First function into derivative of second function. First function is x here. Derivative of e power x is e power x only. Plus second function is e power x. So derivative of x is 1. X derivative dx, t derivative dt. So you can understand here, we can take e power x common, right? E power x into x plus 1 dx equal to dt. Hope we got the numerator term. You see here e power x into 1 plus x dx. Instead of that we can write dt. So now integral e power x into 1 plus x upon cos square of x e power x dx equal to integral, this full term can be written as dt. Dt upon cos square. What is my assumption here? This is t. So integral 1 by cos square t means what? Secant square t dt. Right? What is the integration of secant square t? I know tan t. Because tan x derivative is secant square x. Right? Formulas you should be perfect. So tan of, what is t here? X e power x plus c. Therefore, integral e power x into 1 plus x upon cos square of x e power x can be tan of x e power x plus c. Right? The similar problem as first one, you have here third question. See here, e power x into 1 plus x by sin square of x e power x dx. Instead of cos square, we have sin square. Same question, right? So, we shall solve that. You do yourself and check it with the solution, right? Third one we will do it. Third one is, instead of cos square, we write sin square. This fully same. Instead of cos square, we write c. Right? Correct it. Small change in the solution. So, this is sin square. Right? So, this assumption is same. X e power x equal to t. Write the derivative. First function into derivative of second function. Plus second function into derivative of first function. Full bracket dx equal to d. Take e power x common. X plus 1 dx equal to d. Here we have sin. So here we have sin square t. As per this, this is dt. 1 by sin square means what? You know that cosec square t. What is the integration of cosecant square t? Minus cot t plus c. Because cot theta differentiation is minus cosecant square theta. Cosecant square theta integration is minus cot theta. So here we have minus cot. T means I have x e power x. So therefore, minus cot of xe power x plus. Hope it is clear. Interesting problem. Right, let us solve now second and fourth. Okay, second and fourth we will see now. Second question says 1 by root x sin root x dx. So you might have understood, let root x equal to t, root x derivative 1 by 2 root x dx equal to dt. So you have only dx by root x here, 2 send that side. So 1 by root x dx equal to 2 dt. Now integral 1 by root x sin root x dx equal to integral sin of root x, assumption is t. Instead of dx by root x, we can write it as 2dt. So 2 can be kept outside. Sin t integration is minus cot t cos t plus c. Minus 2 cos t means root x plus c. Hope it is clear. Right? Cos theta differentiation is minus sin theta. Therefore, integral 1 by root x sin root x dx equal to minus 2 cos of root x plus c. That is the way we do it. Now fourth solution, integral e power x plus e power minus x upon e power x minus e power minus x dx. So clearly, if you consider the denominator e power x minus e power minus x equal to t, it is easy to understand e power x derivative is e power x, e power minus x derivative is e power minus x, again minus x derivative we should write, that is minus 1, so plus you will get dx equal to dt. When you write derivative of e power minus x, e power minus x derivative is e power minus x, and the derivative of minus x will be minus 1, so plus it becomes. So the numerator term has come. Now I can take given one, e power x plus e power minus x upon e power x minus e power minus x dx equal to integral, this can be written as dt upon, this is my assumption is t. Now 1 by t integration is log mod t plus c. Log mod t plus c. So log mod t means, what is my assumption here, e power x minus e power minus x plus c. Right? Therefore integral e power x plus e power minus x upon e power x minus e power minus x dx equal to log mod e power x minus e power minus x plus c. That is the end of solution. Okay? 1 by x integration is log mod x. Log mod x derivative is 1 by x. Hope it is clear. Thank you.